When an animal dies outdoors, after about 1 month, all that is left of the poor creature is a pile of hair, skin, and bones. The reason that these parts remain is the simple fact that Mother Nature has very few participants willing and able to consume these materials. The large amounts of keratin in the hair, feather, skin, nails, hooves, and horns of animals make it extremely difficult to digest for nearly every species in our world. Keratin is composed of polymers of amino acids, making it an extremely stable and strong substance. Polymers are simply large chains of molecules composed of many similar smaller chains linked together. In the case of keratin, the most common chain is the amino acid called cysteine. Cysteine contains a high amount of sulfur, and the disulfide bonds in cysteine are a key factor for keratin's durability in nature and a big reason why it is difficult to digest. Think about a time that you may have accidentally burnt or singed your hair. The high amount of sulfur in keratin is the reason why burnt hair smells so strong to us. Just how difficult is keratin to ingest? Consider house cats and wild cats alike that constantly clean, lick, and ingest their fur. Even in the highly acidic digestive tracts of these predatory animals, their ingested hair does not break down. Instead, it accumulates into hair balls that need to be coughed up or even removed for the health of the cat. This shows that keratin is one tough compound. A few select insects, like this webbing clothes moth larva, have evolved to be able to break down the keratin for their own benefit. The digestive tracts in the larva of clothes moths and several species of carpet beetles have adapted to be able to disassemble the disulfide bonds in the keratin and utilize the protein in the hair, skin, and other natural materials. In this sense, these insects are beneficial, and quite frankly, without this particular set of insects, we would have large numbers of partially decomposed animal carcasses lying all around the place. Mankind's only real problem with these insects occurs when we want to preserve certain wools, furs, hides, hooves, antlers, or other keratin-based materials in our homes and museums. The same insects that help us in nature can be a curse in these locations, as they feed on our woolen sweaters and rugs and destroy our precious goods.